step here, that little bit of movement here, indicates to her which side to work. It's a way of recognizing tells. Okay, for the hook, you see that part of that is a warm-up that can be done without any pads. You can do that with hands, get the person moving, dynamically adjusting to your movement in. The other thing that she was doing was having some sort of target that was held at head height. We're looking for the target that she would be fighting, so you vary this over time. The lower hooks that we would do wouldn't be just swung from the arm like that, because that leaves that side exposed for strikes. There's very little cover. So any type of shot down here, like a low hook to the ribs, low floating ribs, or just along the side on the obliques, or even a kidney shot, because in a street fight we don't care about rules. So she has to crouch down either prior to or during her movement. She will stand from here, and then she'll crouch down into the strike and hit at that level, so that she's just level changing and she's keeping her cover in play on the strike, and then also returning quickly to cover to get that elbow back down. So if she fires this strike right now, she gets that elbow back fast. She'll do that just by dropping the arm, or she'll do that by rotating her body so that that is no longer exposed to my attacks. So that movement helps turn her body away from counterattacks. Before the hook training, there's several different ways to do this. One is we're in a really close range and she's got to fire from here. Now she's going to choose whichever type of strike that she wants to do. In this particular case, she's using the hook with the palm strike. So a palm strike is an effective hook as long as she backs it up with the proper mechanics. Again, the same reasoning here is if I'm in a fight with her and she's throwing a hook, but that elbow is not parallel, that's going to skim off and lessen the amount of force that she can transfer through the strike. Part of it will be dissipated over my shoulder or head or however I move. So we want to make sure that those parallel lines are adhered to. So even in a very close range hook, she has to just make sure that the heel toe sway, the hip, and everything else is involved in delivering the amount of power. If she only uses arm strength, that means she's only got the pectoralis that comes in and ties in here, the small muscle groups of the rotator cuff and anterior delt. Those are the only things that are going to come into play. A little bit of bicep, a little bit of tricep antagonistic muscle to hold it through the strike. And what happens is those will fatigue quickly versus somebody that delivers from the ground up with a lot more oomph in a very close short range without having to have giant muscles. That short range motion is delivered best by those mechanics. If she adds power because she's stepping outside, she still puts in her heel toe sway, her hip movement, her rotation of the upper body. As you heard, as you saw, that was a lot of power going into that. So medium range hooks are about here, which is where we would normally be for our jabs, and we're comfortable for that. So medium range, we're throwing that. She's still working the palm strike, which is comfortable for her, which is what she wants to do. Some people will do that solely because of wrist injury, solely because they know that they want to ingrain that as a habit when it comes to a street fight instead of a fist strike, which can break the bones of your hand. So some people train the palm strike so that they don't develop the other type of strike when it counts. Heel toe sway, hip mechanics, gets a lot of good delivery. Good. When she adds movement to it, then she'll add movement that then works protection. Gets that in play. She's out of range of that particular counterattack now. So when I'm working that, doesn't matter which lead. Again, we train both leads, left and right. We have to be efficient in both and capable in both. So either close range, she's got to work heel-toe sway, relax the body. There we go. That's it. There's some power. You can feel that. And back out. Medium range. Good power. Long range extension on hooks. You have to be careful not to hyperextend your elbow. You do not straighten out the elbow. The longest hook you will use is one that still allows you to retain a slight bend in the elbow that won't hyperextend on a hit or hyperextend on my movement. So if she's firing that and I move into it, if this is already at a extended range, my movement in on the power that she's throwing will also add damage to the elbow. So your longest range hook will always be delivered as long as you have enough of a safety measure to the elbow joint. So we can train for speed as well. And the speed indicator is not just her being able to go faster, boom. The speed indicator is on impulse of my threat. So she will employ this as I come in and hold the pad. Important aspect on holding the pads. For the hooks, we never want to hold the hooks like this. It should seem obvious. I put it out there because it's not so obvious to some people that I have trained in the past. This is experience. What you want to do is hooks are thrown from here, fairly close to my head height and slightly in front of. My slightly in front of changes depending on how much I trust this person has control over their body. If it is a new student who is just getting into their body, I do not put this close to my head. I have it out here a little bit further. So when you're working this, take that into consideration. So she's going to sit there in a relaxed state. I can have it two different ways. One is she has no preparation whatsoever, and I move in with the pad and she goes into a strike mode. Notice she also went slightly back. If you are being assaulted and it's a surprise situation, the more time you can buy yourself to think about what's going on, the better. So that stepping off to the side is a good deal, and off at an angle is even better. When I do this and she's prepared, then it's a matter of she's always beating her own time, not anybody else's who you might be training with. It's always her own. She has to get a sense for that, and you can time this. There are things you can buy that actually time the strike. But in this particular case, we're looking at closer range strikes. She's only going to fire at the pad when it's close range. And again, my accompanying movement says threat is coming in, she has to deal with it. Now you saw how she was coming in and starting to turn this way. Now she's going to go outward. She's going to make the strike on her exit. There we go. We relax in between. We don't set up any particular timing. Heel-toe sway, we want to make sure that's in there. Again, I can go slow at this, but she should go fast. And then make sure you get your heel-toe sway in. Now she's going to go diagonal in front. She's going to move toward my outside as I hold. You may not be able to get as much heel-toe sway on this particular one because you're doing a lot of footwork movement. The movement is this. She takes that step as the punch is coming to travel. So we always want to make sure that our base is solid before we fire the punch. She won't do a traveling punch. She won't go here while that's in the air. You just diminish so much of your power and you waste your time and you develop bad habits. So she gets through that position, sets, and then fires. Yeah. So now she's just going to take a longer step out. And if I set up for the other one. There we go. So now she's getting used to my movement in, or a threat movement in, having to adjust dynamically to that, moving at diagonals or away. So again, same movement in, same threat movement in. I can do it for speed, for timing, with absolutely no tell, and just all of a sudden I'm in there. Or I can go, this is part of a drill, we're working like that. I step out and I move, I'm relaxing, I put it into play. She always wants to maintain, because we're working medium range shot to long range shot, because that's hard to really differentiate because of two dynamic bodies moving, especially when I start engaging in this now in a more live fashion. She's gonna go medium to long. She cannot sit there and work close range hooks, which means she has to start perceiving when to move so that she gets to a safer range for the striking. And it may be out here. I may have her go here or here. Coming in. Yep, she has to take that step out. So this is the indicator. I gave her a little bit of a cue that I'm going to be using this one. Initially, that's what you'll do. You'll go here, this one's setting, she knows that that wants to start working. I go like this, it's just enough of an indicator for her to start moving. It was the difference between this prior to going or this prior to going. That small movement is all she needs. That little bit of a step here, that little bit of a movement here indicates to her which side to work. It's a way of recognizing tells. The human body does that. People will generally throw their fist, but with a lot of announcing it, they draw back. The other threat is getting close to you. They might be talking and, hey, you know, blah, blah, blah. There's no tell here, but they may be planning the hook. They may be planning an uppercut from here or from here. You have to have an awareness of your range and never allow anybody to get within that striking range or to where you cannot quickly get to a safe range. And the safe range may be jamming their tools quickly. Now remember, in any altercation in the United States of America, if I touch her, that's assault. If she touches me, even though I'm the one presenting a threat, but she starts engaging and making contact with me, she is now the aggressor in this. And it depends on who happened to have their cameras out and was filming. So to be safe, it's always hands up. Hey, I don't want any problems in backing away, remembering where your exits were and moving toward them. Cover checking for hooks will be done later. That'll be in another video. Suffice it to say, I want to make sure that when she throws a hook and holds it up there, that this line is protected, that she is aiming at the target, not like that. If it's like this, fully exposed. If her shoulder's up, but her head turns in that direction of the strike, I still get full clean shot, and she's also reduced her peripheral awareness toward me. Try to move into those. Yep. Take a step in. Yeah, like you're gonna come around to my back. That's it. Hey, I don't want any of that.